So today we're going to talk about three new verbs in the pretérito, in the preterite. And they do kind of have some little crazy, it's a T90 little crazy thing that makes them irregulares. It says that in the third person singular and plural form, these verbs are going to have a skin change. So what I want you to do right here, I want you to put una estrella, put a star right here by the usted, él, and ella. That's the singular form. And come down and put una estrella, put a star by the ustedes, ellos, y ellas. And señora, I forgot to add the, you may need it still. Singular goes there, plural goes there. So we should know that. So those are going to be the two little tiny places where they have this little bitty change. Aquí tenemos el primer verbo, y es pedir. Pedir in inglés is to ask for. You need to know that the word for is included in the verb. So that's one word in Spanish, pedir, equals three words in English, to ask for. The for is in the verbo. Now, para comprobar un verbo, we know step one, once possible enough, step one to conjugate any verb is what? Drop the IR, drop the N, right? What I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. I'm going to drop the IR, and normally I'd go down and I'd write head. And I'd write it cinco veces, so I'd write it five times. But because I don't want to hear a lot of screaming and yelling about why can't I get this word out? I'm going to show you. We're going to write head and head. We're going to jump down to the nosotros, and we're going to write head right there. So we have three head. Head, head. Now look about pasar. What happens to this verbo is aquí en estas dos formas, in these two forms right here, the E changes to I, and you get E. Right down here, you also get P. So it's head, head, peed, head, peed. Let's do it. It goes like this. Head, head, peed, head, peed. Conmigo. Head, head, peed, head, peed. Again. Head, head, peed, head, peed. Last call. Head, head, peed, head, peed. Now, the rest is real easy. So all we're going to do is we're going to dump on our IR ending. Our ER and IR endings in the pretérito, hopefully we remember them, are E, ISTE, YO, IMOS, IEL. So here I go. E. ISTE. YO. And ACENTO. IMOS. And IEL. That's the only thing that makes this verb irregular. It's this little tiny I right here and this little tiny I right here. Otherwise, it's really good. So pedí in English would be I asked for. I'm not going to write this all the way down. Pediste, you asked for. Pidió, she asked for. So aquí, right down here, let's do these quick examples. They asked you for money. Quiero saber primero. I want to know, is there a word here that tells you cuando? Is there a when word? No. Okay, and that's fine. I told you we need to get in the habit of, okay, there's nada. There's nothing. So put the big symbol for nada. It's a pretérito. If they ask, that would be ellos. Which one would it be? Pedí, pediste, pidió, pedimos, or pidieron? Pidieron. Now I'm going to leave a little bit of space right here, so you do the same. Pidieron. They ask, who? Oh, you. That's my indirect object pronoun. Is it me, te, or le? Which one? Te. It goes right here before the conjugated verb. We hate it there, because that's not what we put it in English. So it goes in Espanol. Ellos te pidieron. Now we see the for, and I guarantee you today, somebody's going to ask me, how much did you say for? There is a word for for, but I told you that pedir means to ask for. It's in there. All you got to do is write the word for money. Mostly say money. Dinero. Te pidieron dinero, or el dinero, if you want to. All right, the next one. We ask for food. I don't know, palabra, is there a word that tells me cuando, a when word? So we just say, hey, no hay nada. There's not one. It's still pretérito. If we ask for, is that pedí, pediste, pidió, pedimos, or pidieron? Pedimos. That takes care of the whole we ask for business. Now all I got to do is food. Como se dice food? Comida. Or pedimos la comida. Remember they use the el, la, los, mas a lot more than we do. You could use your el dinero out there. Alright? So, pedir is to ask for. It's gonna pedir, pedir. Verbo numero dos. Verb number two is sentir. Sentir in English is to feel. Does anybody know in English any words that start with S-E-N-T that have to do with feelings? Sentimental. If you're a sentimental kind of person, what kind of person are you?
That's not
true Pedro. You don't have to be a crybaby. You can be one of those people. Esa. When we were moving out of our old house last week, my mom was going around. That's cinnamon foul. Cinnamon oil, I'm not really sentimental. I was like, throw that away, throw that away, throw that away. She's like, don't you want to get, no, throw that away. Don't you want to keep, no, sell that in the sale. Do you want to keep, no, no, I don't. You're not a sweet boy cinnamon foul. I'm not that sentimental. But some people are sentimental to fly, but you don't have to be private. All right, so if I was to keep that, we're going to drop the IR. We're going to go with the sit. Where do we go? I'm going to go sit. Sit. I'm going to sit down in those sotros, and I'm going to write sit. So I have three cents. Y aquí, pues, and then I'm going to change over. And that's not what I'm going to write here. Instead of cent, it's going to be seat. So all I did is change an each one up. And I skip right down here and I write seat. So this one was pet, pet, pee, pet, pee. This one's going to be cent, cent, seat, cent, seat. Let's do it. Cent, cent, seat, cent, seat. Con amigo. Cent, cent, seat, cent, seat. That's sad. Again. Send, send, sing, send, seat with pet ear. Pet, pee, with sent ear. Send, send, sing, send, sing. So if you want to say I felt, that would be send, tea. I felt. We know a whole bunch of emotions, hopefully. What's my happy? Feliz, alegre, or contento? I'm going to go with feliz because I'm feeling floja. I'm feeling lazy today. Keep up with it. See, what's my sad word? Triste. Senti triste. Yes, you need to know these. What's my mad word? Furioso. Enojado. Enfadado. And let's add one. Tired. I felt tired today. That would be cansado. Unless you're a girl, you'd be cansada. So, senti feliz, senti triste, senti furiosa, senti cansada. So, I think you felt sick yesterday. What's my when word, the important word that tells me when? Yesterday. I'm going to underline yesterday and say, oh, that's a specific time in the past. Preterito, el, con un acento, sent, sin, tio. You can't get sick. What's my word for sick? Enfermo, again. El sitio enfermo ayer. Y si hablas español y vas a decir el sitio enfermo está bien, pero no vamos a hacer eso. And if you didn't understand that, then I don't. I felt sick today. What's the word that tells me when? Today. Here's my question. Can I use today and make it a past tense sentence? Yeah, like today for breakfast, I ate some cereal already. So, sin. T, I don't know why I get too serious. Sinti, enfermo, quiere today, what's my today word?
Hoy.
Aquí estamos en el último verbo. We will now move to the last. Oh, I didn't go through and do these for you. Sorry. I got all excited. Sinti, what about La Forma too? That would be Sintiste. She felt would be Sintio, con un acento. We felt Sint. Dimos, sentimos que ella sintiera. So we have pet,
how does it go?
Pet, pet, pee, sint, and the last one, mentir. We play that game. What's that game called? Mentiroso. What's a mentiroso? A liar. So mentir means to lie. Yes. So we drop the IR in mentir. And we're going to get mint. Y aquí la forma nosotros. Mint. Uh-huh. Y what do you think we're going to have to do? Go in and make you usted el ene. Yeah, it's not mint, but it is meat. So we have pet, mint, let's do it. Mint, meat. Oh, go ahead. Mint, con pedir. Pet, pee, con sentir. Sin, con mentir. Mint, mean. What about I lied? Mentir. You lied because you're a liar. Mentiste. She lied. Ella mintió. We Eskimos, and instead of CSCAS, mean Tierra.
Mm-hmm.
And in the past, she lied to me. Is there a word that tells me cuando? Is there a win word?
Mm-hmm.
No. So we put the big scene below for nada. Boom. Preterito. Ella. Could I use a myth or a meat for Ella? Meat. Uh-huh, I'm gonna skip some space, and it's gonna be meat, yo, because she's the one that lied, and she lied to me. Ella, meh, means yo. You, informal, lied last night. Hay una palabra, is there a word that tells me when? Last night? Boom. Preterito. Oh, that says yo. Oh, that's a fake news. Fix that. You, informal, lied. If you lied, would that be a myth or a meat? Yes, again. Mint. Mint. Tiste. Anoche.